Topic: The skeletal system of vertebrates. The vertebrate skeletal system is an endoskeleton enclosed by other body tissues. The endoskeleton consists of two main types of supportive tissues, that is cartilage and bone. Cartilage is a connective tissue much softer than the bone. Cartilage consists of cells called chondrocytes, fibers and cellular matrix. Here in this diagram you see these are chondrocytes and fibers and cellular matrix are also present here. Cartilage is a specialized type of connective tissue that provides a site for muscle attachment. It aids in movement at joints and it provides support. Bone or osseous tissue. The most rigid form of connective tissue is called bone. Composition of bone. Bone tissue is homogeneous organic ground substance which also contains inorganic salts, mainly calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate. When an animal needs the calcium or phosphate stored within bones, metabolic reactions which are under the endocrine control release the required amounts of calcium and phosphate. Bone cells are called osteocytes, and osteocytes are present in minute chambers called lacunae. In this diagram you see that this is an osteocyte which is present in a lacuna. Here these are the lacunae, and in these lacunae osteocytes are present. Lacunae are arranged in concentric rings. A concentric ring or a concentric circle is a ring with a common center. These are concentric rings because they have a common center. So lacunae are arranged in concentric rings around osteonic canals. Here you see that these are lacunae, and these lacunae are arranged in concentric rings around the canal, which is named as osteonic canal. It is also named as central canal or Haversian canal, and this was formerly named as Haversian system. Bone cells communicate with nearby cells by means of cellular processes passing through small channels called canaliculi. So here you see that these are osteocytes, and they communicate with the nearby cells by means of cellular processes passing through small channels which are named as canaliculi. Functions of bone. Bone provide a point of attachment for muscle movement. Bone transmits the force of muscular contraction from one part of the body to another during movement. Bones support and protect the internal tissues of many animals. Like here you see that this skull bone, it protects the brain, and here the rib cage, it protects the lungs and heart. Bones also store reserve calcium and phosphate. Bones manufacture blood cells. Like here you see that in this bone, the bone marrow is a site where blood cells are produced. The skeletal system of vertebrates, the skeleton of fishes. Both cartilaginous and bony endoskeletons first appeared in vertebrates. Since water has a buoyant effect on the fish body, the requirements for skeletal support is not as demanding in these vertebrates as it is in terrestrial vertebrates. Although most vertebrates have a well-defined vertebral column, the jawless vertebrates do not have this vertebral column. The skeleton of fishes. Vertebral column is absent in the jawless fishes. Here you see that this is a lamprey and this is the hagfish, and they do not have a vertebral column. Lampreys only have isolated cartilaginous blocks along the notochord. And hagfishes do not even have these. So hagfishes do not have a vertebral column or cartilaginous blocks along the notochord. Skeleton of jawed fishes. Jawed fishes have axial skeleton. Most jawed fishes have an axial skeleton. Axial skeleton is named as axial skeleton because it forms a longitudinal axis of the body. Axial skeleton includes a notochord, ribs, cartilaginous or bony vertebrae. Muscles used in locomotion attach to the axial skeleton, and here you see the axial skeleton in fish. The skeletal system of vertebrates, the skeleton of tetrapods. Tetrapod animals are actually the four limbed animals, and these includes amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. Tetrapods must lift themselves to walk on land. For the earliest terrestrial animals, support and locomotion were difficult and complicated processes. The first amphibians need support to replace the buoyancy of water. Adaptations for support and movement on land occurred over a period of approximately 200 million years. During this evolution, the tetrapod endoskeleton became modified for support on land. The skeleton of tetrapods, adaptations in the skeleton of vertebrates. Presence of intervertebral disc. Intervertebral disc is an important adaptation for the tetrapods. The intervertebral disc articulate with the adjoining vertebrae. Here you see that in this diagram, this is the intervertebral disc, and this intervertebral disc articulate with adjoining vertebrae. The intervertebral disc help hold the vertebral column together, and they also absorb shock and provide joint mobility. Bone replaced cartilage in the ribs, and which make the ribs more rigid. So the presence of bones in the ribs is also an important adaptation for the tetrapods. Various types of connective tissue that connect to the axial skeleton help keep elevated portions from the sagging. As you know that ligaments and tendons, they are connective tissues. So various type of connective tissues like ligaments and tendons that connect to axial skeleton help keep elevated portions from sagging. Appendages became elongated and support on hard surface. Like here you see, this is the skeleton of a frog, and here you see that these are appendages, and these appendages become elongated, and these elongated appendages support on the hard surface, and changes in the shoulder, here you see that the changes in the shoulder enabled the neck to move more freely as compared to the fish. The human endoskeleton. Human endoskeleton consists of bones and cartilage, and adult human body has 206 bones. The human endoskeleton has two major parts, axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton. The axial skeleton in humans, here in this diagram you see the yellow portions indicates the axial skeleton. The axial skeleton is made up of skull, vertebral column, sternum and ribs. Appendicular skeleton, in these photos, the red portion indicates the appendicular skeleton. Appendicular skeleton is composed of the appendages, the pectoral girdle and the pelvic girdle, and these girdles attach the upper and lower appendages to the axial skeleton. Summary of today's lecture. In this lecture, we have studied the skeletal system of vertebrates. Vertebrates possess endoskeleton. and this endoskeleton has supportive tissues which are cartilage and bone. The skeleton of fishes, skeleton of jawless fishes, only a single only one type of jawless fish, that is lamprey, it has isolated cartilaginous blocks along the notochord. Skeleton of jawed fishes have axial skeleton. The skeleton of tetrapods, tetrapod skeleton has some important adaptations. These include the presence of intervertebral disc and the bone which replaced the which has replaced cartilage in the ribs, appendages which became elongated, and changes in the shoulder enabled the neck to move more freely. Human endoskeleton includes axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton includes skull, vertebral columns, sternum, and ribs, while appendicular skeleton includes appendages, the pectoral girdle, and pelvic girdles.